Fashion design basics. Blocks are the means by which you translate your concept design into a garment that fits the body. Drafting the blocks part two, using imperial and metric measurements. The front bodice. Check out fashion design resources on angelacain.com/fashion design. Pattern drafting ebooks. One sheet drafting guides. Yes, all this information on one sheet. Thirty steps to drafting the perfect bodice block all in one place. See my site for details. In part one, we drafted the back bodice. This is how the back bodice will look when finished. Now we turn our attention to drafting the front. The bodice front is drafted side by side with the back and shares important construction lines. Here again are the measurements I'm using for this draft. This is the draft so far. The front neckline. From the centre front line, measure the neck width along the top line. This is again the bust measurement divided by 8 plus 1¼ inches, 3 centimetres, and then halved. But this time we deduct 1/4 inch, 0.5 centimetres. This makes the front neck width 1/4 inch, 0.5 centimetres, less than the back neck width. This helps the neckline to sit correctly. Label this point the front neck point. From the top line, measure down the CF 3 inches 7.5 centimetres and label base of neck. This measurement can be 2¾ inches 7 centimetres for smaller sizes or up to 3⅜ inch 8.5 centimetres for larger sizes. The neck curve. Square down from the neck point and across from base of neck. And then draw a guideline of 45 degrees from the angle and mark off 1¼ inches, 3 centimetres. Draw the neckline curve through the points. The front shoulder. For all sizes, measure along the top line 6½ inches, 16.5 centimetres, from centre front and square down 1¾ inches, 4.5 centimetres. Draw the shoulder line from the front neck point through the point just drafted and extend beyond. This is a provisional shoulder seam. The bust dart position. Measure out from the centre front 1/4 chest width and draw a guideline parallel to CF up to meet the shoulder seam and down to 1 inch 2.5 centimetres below the bust line. This would be the point of the bust dart. The bust dart. Where this line meets the shoulder, measure 3/4 inch, 2 centimetres, to the left along the shoulder line. Mark this point and draw a dart line from there to the bust dart point. Measure a dart width of 6 centimetres along the shoulder and draw the other dart line to meet the bust dart point. Bust dart variations. Dart width varies from 2¼ inches, 5.5 centimetres in small sizes, and up to 4 inches, 10 centimetres for the larger sizes, but also depends on the fullness of the bust. I am drafting for a small bosom. Refer to my table of average measurements. Check the info button. This is a variation that you may need to fine-tune at a later stage. The front shoulder point. With the dart drawn in, mark off the shoulder measurement. Add the dart width to give you the shoulder point. The chest line. Measure the distance from the base of the neck to the bust line. Divide this by 3 and measure that distance up from the bust line. Square across and label it the chest line. The front chest point. Measure along the chest line 1/2 times chest width plus the width of the dart at this level. And mark chest point. The front underarm point. To find the front underarm point, we use CB to back armhole guide measurement, taken from the back bodice draft, which was calculated as 1/2 back width plus 1/4 inch, 0.5 centimetres. So 1/2 bust minus CB to back armhole guide gives us the distance from centre front to the front underarm point. Mark the front underarm point. This will give you 4 inches, 10 centimetres for bust ease overall. This will increase to 5 inches, 13 centimetres for extra large, and can be a little less in extra small sizes. Sleeveless garments may require less ease. Plot the armhole curve. Draw a guideline joining front shoulder point and front chest point. Halfway along, square out a line 3/8 of an inch, 1 centimetre in length, towards CF. This is a guide for the armhole curve. Square down from the front chest point to the bust line. And from there, draw a line at 45 degrees. Mark a point along this line 1/2 inch, 1.5 centimetres, or up to 1 inch, 2.5 centimetres, for larger sizes from the angle. This is a guide for the lower part of the armhole. Draw the armhole curve. Join all points with a smooth curving line. Take a curve a little below the bust line before it joins the underarm point. Find the hip point. Calculate 1/4 hip measurement plus 1 1/4 inches, 3 centimetres, and use this to find the front hip point, measured from CF along the hip line. Join front underarm point and front hip point with a straight guideline for the provisional side seam. The true bust line. Draw the true bust line 2 inches, 4 centimetres, below the bust line and square across to CB. Mark on it the bust point in line with the bust dart. Finishing the block is next in part 3. Fashion design and pattern cutting on angelicaine.com. Check out my one sheet guides, the complete drafting process on one sheet. If you like this tutorial format, please subscribe for more of the same. Continue to episode 3, and thank you for watching this series.